Okay, now we're getting into 2 Chronicles 21. We're coming to the end of the time of King Jehoshaphat as king, so we got to learn about the next king, and is he going to be a righteous king, or are we going to have wickedness and problems? Verse 1, now Jehoshaphat slept with his fathers and was buried with his fathers in the city of David, and Jehoram, his son, reigned in his stead. So this is Jehoram is Jehoshaphat's son, or Asa's grandson. Verse 2, and he had brethren, the sons of Jehoshaphat, Azariah and Jehiel and Zechariah and Azariah and Michael and Shephatiah. All these were the sons of Jehoshaphat, king of Israel. And their father gave them great gifts of silver and of gold and precious things, with fenced cities in Judah. But the kingdom gave he to Jehoram, because he was the firstborn. Now when Jehoram was risen up to the kingdom of his father, he strengthened himself and slew all his brethren with the sword, and divers also of the princes of Israel. Do you think Jehoram has a bit of a complex, worried about somebody stabbing in the back or taking his authority from him? Probably. So he's not being a righteous king, unfortunately. Verse 5, Jehoram was 32 years old when he began to reign, so he reigned 8 years in Jerusalem. And he walked in the way of the kings of Israel, like as did the house of Ahab. So remember, he's the king of Judah, but he's acting like a king of Israel, meaning idolatry, wickedness, problems. For he had sought the daughter of Ahab to wife, and he wrought that which was evil in the eyes of the Lord. So he goes after the daughter of Ahab, who Ahab was the king of Israel, remember, and then he died in that war against Syria. And so now we have his daughter is going to marry Jehoram to try to do some unification there, but it was not for unification, it was for more power, basically. Verse 7, howbeit the Lord would not destroy the house of David because of the covenant he had made with David, and as he promised to give a light to him and to his sons forever. In his days the Edomites revolted from under the dominion of Judah and made themselves a king. So the Edomites, if you remember, were a group of people who lived in Canaan prior to Israel getting there. They basically said, we promise to be your servants forever if you don't kill us. And so Judah said, all right, that sounds fine. So they've been their servants basically the whole time. And now they've decided to revolt against Judah because Judah's gone wicked. They're going to appoint themselves their own king. So there's this new king of the Edomites inside the kingdom of Judah. Verse 9, then Jehoram went forth with his princes and all his chariots with him. And he rose up by night and smote the Edomites which compassed him in and the captains of the chariots. So the Edomites revolted from under the hand of Judah unto this day. The same time also did Libnah revolt from under his hand, because he had forsaken the Lord God of his fathers. Moreover, he made high places in the mountains of Judah and caused the inhabitants of Jerusalem to commit fornication and compelled Judah thereto. So making the high places, fertility rights, privileges, lots of immorality as they're doing these fertility rites and things in the high places, the groves, those kinds of things, the idol worship, going back to those old problems. Verse 12, and there came a writing to him from Elijah the prophet. So this is the time of Elijah, saying, thus saith the Lord God of David thy father, because thou hast not walked in the ways of Jehoshaphat thy father, nor in the ways of Asa king of Judah, but hast walked in the way of the kings of Israel, and hast made Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem to go a-whoring, like to the whoredoms of the house of Ahab, and also hast slain thy brethren of thy father's house, which were better than thyself. Behold, with a great plague will the Lord smite thy people and thy children and thy wives and all thy goods. Thou shalt have great wickedness and disease by disease of thy bowels until thy bowels fall out by reason of the sickness day by day. Wow. You got to admit, that is so crazy. A plague will smite the people, all your children, all the wives, all the goods, so things going bad, spoiling, problems, and you shall have a great sickness by disease of thy bowels, that your bowels fall out by reason of the sickness. That is pretty wild. I'm trying to think off the top of my head, what kind of a disease would that be that would just cause your bowels to come out? There are some that could possibly cause that. Maybe some extra bloating or some other problems that cause some issues. Definitely a lot more than just hemorrhoids, to get that to happen. But that's pretty crazy. So lots of problems and challenges. We can see when the wicked kings are there, they have problems. When the righteous kings are there, things go good. Verse 16, moreover, the Lord stirred up against Jehoram the spirit of the Philistines and of the Arabians that were near the Ethiopians. And they came up into Judah and brake into it and carried away all the substance that was found in the king's house, and his sons also, and his wives, so that there was never a son left, save Jehoahaz, the youngest of his sons. And after all this, the Lord smote him with his in his bowels with an incurable disease. And it came to pass that in the process of time, after the end of 2 years, his bowels fell out by reason of his sickness. So he died of sore diseases, and his people made no burning for him like the burning of his fathers. That was burning the incense and those things to give him a full celebration of his life and honoring him in death. They didn't. He was probably a bit of a jerk to his people and taxed them a lot and had problems. So they buried him, but they didn't give him the full rites. Verse 20, 32 years old was he when he began to reign. He reigned in Jerusalem 8 years and departed without being desired. Tells you he wasn't a very favorite king. Howbeit, they buried him in the city of David, but not in the sepulchers of the kings. Again, that's another indication. Yes, he was a king, so we've got to bury him in the city of David, but he was not a good king. He was a terrible king, and so we're not going to give him the full ceremonial rites and honors of a king. We're just going to go bury him, basically, because we don't like him. And so that tells you what kind of a ruler he was for his people. Pretty crazy what's going on. So jump over to chapter 22 next, as we understand who comes next in this, and are the next kings going to follow the same pattern? Probably will. Hopefully we get a righteous king. Let's see what we get.